This is a deep dive on the DT Swiss 240 Ratchet DEG hub. We're going to cover the technical elements, but also get my honest views on both the new hub and DT Swiss's direction by talking about what you won't read in the press releases. Bear with me here, because to really understand the new hub, we need a history lesson on the older ones. As recently as 5 years ago, DT Swiss really only sold two hubs, the cheaper 350 and the more expensive 240, and there honestly wasn't much difference between the two. Both used the now famous system of two clutch plates, now called Ratchet, and all parts were completely interchangeable between the two, with the only difference being more machining on the more expensive 240 to save weight. But a lot has changed in that time. DT introduced the low-end 3-pole 370, then the Ratchet LN drive system, then they upgraded the 350 to be more like the old 240, introduced the new Ratchet EXP drive system, then the Ratchet EXP oversized system, and now the Ratchet DEG drive system. Whew! Most of these hubs share the same end caps. Some share the same hub internals but not free hub bodies. Others share the same free hub bodies but not hub internals. So what used to be a very simple product range is now broken up, with DT's goal being that each niche of cycling has its own model of hub at different price points. And the Ratchet DEG has arrived to fill that all-mountain enduro niche. DT Swiss do not specifically recommend the DEG hubs for e-bike, but this use is not excluded. It's currently only available at the 240 price level, but my guess is that when we see this at a 350 price level, within a year. The major change is taking the star ratchets that DT Swiss has been famous for and making them much, much larger to allow for more engagement points. Rather than maxing out at 54 points of engagement, the new Ratchet DEG comes with 90. For slow technical mountain biking, having a faster engagement hub is a real improvement. Honestly, I'm approaching the Ratchet DEG hubs with optimism but caution. The classic DT Swiss Ratchet hubs have proven themselves to be one of the most durable hubs on the market and have excellent bearing life, but the more recent Ratchet EXP was plagued with issues at launch, and even once those were fixed, the bearing drag and bearing life can leave a lot to be desired. The launch of the Ratchet DEG was delayed around 6 months, which could be for any number of supply chain or engineering issues, but it does mean a rocky start when I'm sure DT Swiss were hoping for a smooth launch. Will Ratchet DEG take DT Swiss back to the top of the rankings in an increasingly competitive market? The durability of any new product is always unknown and is only a question that time can answer. 240 Ratchet DEG hubs are only available in 6-bolt rotor mount and only with J-band spokes. Front hubs are available only in 110x15mm boost with a torque cap end cap option, and the rear hubs are only available in 148x12 boost or 157x12 super boost. Hubs are either 28 or 32 hole. It's worth noting that there is no HG free hub body option, only XD and micro spline. So these will only work with the more expensive cassettes from Shimano and SRAM. Production hubs are matte black with red bands and look very similar to other hubs in the DT Swiss range. The durability of this newer coating has been a really good improvement over the old painted hubs. At launch, they offered a limited edition glossy painted wet red version with white text, which will look absolutely lovely on the right bike. And with only 240 pairs of these offered worldwide, they'll no doubt be a collector's item, although the thick, glossy paint will almost certainly chip with time. To celebrate DT Swiss's 30th anniversary, there's also a limited edition polished silver hub set with special silver end caps and a silver free hub body, a throwback to the Hoogie brand that developed the Star Ratchet system before selling it to DT Swiss. The extra engagement points of the DEG hubs have more of a high-pitched clicky sound than the Ratchet or the Ratchet EXP hubs. At 274 grams, the rear Ratchet DEG hub is 49 grams heavier than its EXP brother. A few years ago, lightweight, big diameter 29-inch aluminum rims made flange geometry made a really noticeable difference to wheel stiffness. However, in today's modern world of boost hubs and wider aluminum and carbon rims, our test data shows very little real-world difference. But with that said, while the non-drive side flange is in a similar place, the drive side flange is larger than both the older Ratchet and EXP hubs, so the wheel's lateral stiffness will be slightly higher, which is a good thing for the type of riding this hub is designed for. There's no change to the 240 front hub, so take a look at our other deep dive videos for that. Let's take a look at the rear hub. What is compatible with other hubs? The end caps and nothing else. Thankfully, these use the same end caps as almost every other hub in the DT Swiss range, although with each free hub body type requiring a different drive side end cap, and with end caps being offered in gloss black with this ridge, matte black with the ridge, there is a good chance of getting confused. DT go to the effort of laser etching the free hub body type onto the end cap, which is great, but it would be even better if they said what axle type it's for, or ideally wrote an easy to use part number on it. End caps are friction fit using a standard N70 O-ring, and it's a little known secret that these are easily replaced if you have problems with end caps falling off. Once we pull it apart, the most obvious thing are these large ratchet rings. You can certainly see the family resemblance to the other DT Swiss models, but these internals are significantly larger and therefore not interchangeable. Unlike Ratchet EXP, where one side is threaded into the hub, each DEG ratchet has its own spring. Unlike the tapered spring design of the ratchet hubs, which we often see installed backwards, these are symmetrical. Also, like the other DT Swiss hubs, the ratchets are flat. I believe this is one of the contributing factors for the early EXP issues, as when your axle flexes, the ratchet's ability to contact with each other is reduced. As the DEG ratchets are larger, this is potentially more of an issue. On other models of DT Swiss hub, there is a thick aluminum spacer separating the hub and the free hub body, but on the Ratchet DEG hub, this is just a tiny shim. If you're familiar with White Industries hubs, it's the exact same 0.5mm thick DIN 988 washer, and honestly, I'm not a big fan of this setup, as tiny hub internals tend to get lost or damaged easier than larger ones. The free hub bodies are not interchangeable with any other hubs in the DT Swiss range. It's a shame to see the seal permanently attached to the free hub body and not a replaceable part, as this is what causes a lot of the drag issues we see on other models of DT hub. Ratchet DEG uses the same super expensive DT Swiss grease as the rest of the range. It's supposed to be a high pressure grease, which works better when squished, but honestly it works really well, and most of the time when we see DT hubs with chipped internals, they've been using an off-brand grease, so I think it's worth the money. By oversizing all of the internals, two really important features are opened up. First, if you have ever serviced a Ratchet or Ratchet EXP hub, you will know how hard it is to remove the threaded ring to access the drive side bearing. These can be bloody tight. No more. On the Ratchet DEG hubs, the drive side bearing can be easily removed. Woohoo! Secondly, the extra space means the drive side bearing is moved outwards. This gives the bearings a wider stance, which should lead to both better bearing life and fewer broken axles. Speaking of bearings, the 240 DEG uses a steel 15x26x7mm bearing on both sides of the hub. This is the same bearing that's used in most of the EXP model hubs, and they're not renowned for their bearing durability, and it's a smaller bearing than the 15x28x7 bearing used in the traditional ratchet hubs, which do have very good bearing life. DT's tech docs have always been really good, and the DEG is no different, with good exploded parts diagrams and good service instructions. Combine the excellent instructions with the new design not requiring the threaded ring to be removed to replace the bearings, and the DEG hubs are super simple to service. I did get a chuckle at the tech doc saying how pedaling tightens the ratchet ring and therefore it requires a high force to loosen. This little tidbit is missing from every other DT Swiss manual where the threaded ring is required to be removed to service the bearings, and is one of the major complaints of that design. The tech docs also have some tips on how to inspect the ratchet rings for wear and when to replace them. People often don't treat DT Swiss ratchets as consumable parts, but this is a good reminder that they are. Look, I'm on the fence here as to whether DT Swiss are heading in the right direction. I think the mountain bike market wants one hub which can do everything by being modular and interchangeable. For our customers, this is the big selling point of Hope Pro 5, Dial Hubs, and 1UP's new hubs. DT seem to be heading in the opposite direction by making a different platform for every type of riding. However, the DEG hubs look really well made. The extra engagement points are great, and the ability to easily service and replace bearings is fantastic. I feel like the price tag is pretty high, and I can't help but think that a $350 price version of these will be really popular. The hub market is becoming increasingly competitive, and DT Swiss are stepping it up with the DEG. Is it enough?